everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those who doesn't know me, I'm Ruby Tamang and I have completed my Master of Education and right now I'm pursuing PhD in Education from a central university, that is Northeastern Hill University, Shillong. So today's discussion point is on what are the frequently asked VIWA questions in BEd macro internship. So macro internship here means the internship that lasts for around 3 to 4 months. Therefore, in order to collect these frequently asked questions, I have interviewed 6 people who were in my contact who have already completed their Bachelor of Education and many of them has also completed their Master of Education. Therefore, I would first like to acknowledge the contribution that these people have made, which has helped me in order to make this video. So these frequently asked questions in VIWA that I'm going to discuss now are the contribution of all these people along with my own input. So now let us go to the main content. So the first and foremost thing is, at the end of the macro internship, you will have an interview or VIWA from an external. In that case, what you have to do is, you need to bring all your documents that you are supposed to submit. So it varies from university to university or be at institute to institute. So therefore, this can be different according to the college. Therefore, you need to know what are the things that you have to submit and you need to submit it in a serial manner and keep it in one file altogether so that it will look more organized and systematic. And you also need to carry your teaching aids. Say for example, if you have used a chart or a model while teaching in the school, so you need to also carry those things during the VIWA. So keep in mind these 2 things, like the documents and files that you have to submit along with the teaching aids that you have used. So these 2 you will have to submit. And in the document, make sure that you have labeled everything correctly. So don't make mistakes in that, because all this will also matter a lot. So now the most probably asked first question is, external may ask you to tell about yourself. So in this question, you need to introduce yourself first and then you need to mention your background, like if you have completed your degree or your bachelor degree, and then which background you belong to, whether you are from social science background or science or mathematics or language. And along with that, also mention the name of the school where you went for your internship and also the class where you teach during your internship. Say for example, if you have taken classes in elementary section, so it can be class 6, 7, 8 or any class that you have taken, which level were given to you during your internship, you need to mention that. So next is which subject you taught during your internship, you would also have to mention that. So all this you will have to mention in the introduction section when you are asked to introduce yourself. And the questions that I'm discussing here in this video may not be asked in the exact serial manner that I'm explaining right now. It might be different from person to person. So don't presume that these are the questions that will be asked in a serial manner. So it can jumble from here to there, from person to person. Depends on the external. The external may also ask questions on, tell me about your experience during your internship. So in this question, what they are actually trying to look for is that if you have actually attained the skills and competencies that are supposed to be attained by a person who have undergone an internship. These are the practical skills which are attained only after the actual internship. In this question, you may share your teaching experience, like how you felt while teaching and what are the skills that you gain at the end of your internship. And in this case, speak out the truth, don't fake yourself, because if you do, they will come to know, they will ask you questions related to that topic. Therefore, don't fake it and just tell the truth. And here you can also share the positive experience as well as the negative experience. Say for example, the positive experiences may be what are the things that you saw that motivated you to do your work as a teacher, and it may also be some initiative that you have taken in the school level during your internship. So these are the things that you can share, the positive aspects. And when you're sharing your negative experiences, make sure that you also justify your negative experiences as of how you overcome that negative experiences and make it into a positive one. See for example, if you have faced some negative experiences, such as there was a child in the class who was not listening to you and who didn't complete the homework. So in that case, this is a negative experience So in that case, how you overcome that situation, you can also share that. It will show that instead of having negative experiences and negative environment, you still came up with a solution which actually helped you out and the student as well. And it also shows your competencies as a teacher to manage a difficult situation. The next question is, the external may also ask some of the theoretical aspects, such as what are the professional qualities and skills that are required to become a teacher. So this question was very frequently asked among all the six participants whom I have interviewed. So these are very basic. I think you already know, if you are doing a BEd, then you already know what are the qualities of a good teacher. If not, then you need to find out the answers and prepare yourself for that. And the next is, the external may also ask you questions related to teaching methods. So the answer for this question depends on the subject that you are teaching. So as we all know that different subjects use different teaching methods. Say for example, if you are teaching a student a mathematical subject, then what are the teaching methods that you use? Say for example, the teacher may use inductive method and deductive method. So these are some of the methods that are used in mathematics. And in, say for example, in science subject, the inquiry method is used, the experimental method is used. And similarly, in other social science subject, you will have to tell what are the methods that you use in the subject that you taught during your internship. So the next is, teacher will also ask questions related to lesson planning. So the external may ask, what are the objectives of your lesson planning? He or she may took any lesson and ask you about what are the objectives of this lesson, particular lesson planning. Or he or she might also give you one topic according to your subject and then ask you to tell you some of the objectives of that particular topic. If you are supposed to teach that topic, then what would be the objective of that lesson? When it comes to lesson planning, the external may also ask the different types of domains and the objectives that are there in that different domains. Say for example, we have three domains, the cognitive, affective and psychomotor domain. So in the cognitive domain, we have objectives such as knowledge, understanding, application, and all this. You need to remember all this. The external may ask questions based on that. The questions may also be asked on what are the different action verbs according to these objectives. Say for example, what are the action verbs that are used when you are asking questions based on knowledge level and based on understanding level. When it comes to lesson planning, the question may also be arise on what are the expected learning outcomes of a particular lesson. So you'll have to remember all that, and you will also have to have presence of mind, because in some situation the external also give you a new topic according to your subject, and he or she might also ask you to frame objectives and learning outcome on that particular moment. Therefore, you need to be very careful. So now that we have discussed the lesson planning, the next is the approaches of lesson planning. So in the approaches of lesson planning, external may ask you which approach you use for your lesson planning. Say for example, there is Herbertian approach of lesson planning and there is constructivist approach of lesson planning. So which approach did you use? Say for example, if you use a 5E model of lesson planning, then the external may ask you the components of that 5E models. That is, all those 5E you will have to explain. External may also ask you what are the activities that are used when you are engaging the students. Such type of questions may be asked. The next area on which the questions are asked is micro teaching skills. When it comes to micro teaching skills, most probably asked questions are what are the different micro teaching skills and what are the components of a particular micro teaching skills. And the external may also ask you about, give an example of a particular component. Say for example, positive verbal reinforcement is one of the component of stimulus variation. So in that case, the teacher may ask you, give me some of the example of positive verbal reinforcement. So likewise, you have to recall and remember all these aspects of micro teaching skills and its components, and also the various examples that follows. So the next question which is asked is on the area of teaching aids. In this case, the external may ask you questions on what are the different types of teaching aids, such as we have projective teaching aids and non-projective teaching aids. So the external may also ask you what are the different types of projective teaching aids. So in projective teaching aids, we have a PowerPoint presentation, we have a film strips. So these are some of the projective type of teaching aids. And in non-projective type of teaching aids, the example are chart model, and the blackboard or whiteboard, whatever that is. So these are examples of non-projective teaching aids. Such type of questions may be asked, so you need to remember these examples of projective and non-projective teaching aids. Since we are discussing on teaching aids right now, so the external will also observe what are the teaching aids that you prepare and brought in the table in that particular day. So he or she might ask you how you prepared it and how you use it. Therefore, there is an impression among the externals that if you make a sustainable teaching aid, then it will be more appreciated. Instead of making very costly teaching aids, try to be more creative while making your teaching aids. Bring out some sustainable aspects of your teaching aids. So in that case, the external may also be very much impressed by you. So the next topic is, the questions are also asked from areas of action research. So now action research has become an integral part of this BEd program in most of the teacher training institutions. Therefore, questions may also come on action research. Even during my Viva, the external asked me about the steps of action research and also asked me about what were the educational implications of action research. During our BEd, we also submitted the report of action research because action research was an integral part of our syllabus. Therefore, we also had to implement it in our school where we got our internship. So I have also submitted the entire action research report. Therefore, the questions that external asked me on that was the steps of action research, the educational implications of action research, and how to incorporate action research in day-to-day classroom activities. So these were the questions that were asked on action research. So the next very important aspect that is frequently asked, especially during this digital era, is on the area of ICT in education. In this area, the questions may ask on what are different types of ICT tools that are used in teaching learning process. And the next is you might be also asked on what are the merits and demerits of using ICT. And one more question that is asked on ICT is that how ICT can be used to make classroom more inclusive. So if this question is asked, you need to explain like how with the help of ICT, the classroom can be more inclusive. Say for example, if there is children with special needs, then with the help of ICT, those students can also be benefited. Say for example, if there is a child in the class who cannot hear, so for that child, if you make an e-content with audio and video and also a subtitle, then in that case, the child who cannot hear can also understand the e-content by reading the subtitles or the captions of the video. These are some of the examples of how you can use ICT in order to make the classroom learning more inclusive to the students. So the next area that is mostly asked in BEd Viva is the area of special education. In this particular inclusive education part, the Viva questions mostly asked are, what are the different ways which are used to make classroom more inclusive? So this is somewhat related to ICT. Because when you use ICT, then classroom becomes more inclusive. And the external may also ask if you have come across any student with special needs during your internship period and how you tackle that situation, how you manage the classroom in order for the children with special needs to go at par with the other children in the classroom. So such kind of questions may be asked, how you manage the classroom and what are the activities that you use order for both the children with special needs as well as the normal children to interact with each other in the same classroom environment. So the next area that on which the Viva is asked is on the evaluation process. The external may ask you what are the different types of tests that is used in a classroom. Some external have also asked about what were the differences between teacher-made tests and standardized tests. Also, what were the difference between non-reference tests and criterion reference tests. So these were the Viva questions that we are asked. And when it comes to evaluation process, you will be also asked on questions as of how you prepare the blueprint and what were the aspects with the help of which you have prepared your question paper. So say for example, we have marks according to the weightage of the question, according to the difficulty level. So these things you will have to explain to the external if they are asked questions related to these aspects. And the next area on which the external may ask is also on medial education. So many of my friends whom I have interviewed were also asked on when and how they use the remedial teaching for the students. So in that case, you will have to tell them as of when and how you use the remedial teaching. Say, for example, some teacher might have also provided extra help through online media, or it might be after the class, after the end of the school. Therefore, you will have to mention that when and how you have given a remedial education for a particular child, and what was the status of the child, and why there was a need to give such kind of remedial teaching to that particular child, and also the learning outcome. If after providing the remedial teaching, if the child learning process improve or not, you will also have to mention that. And the next area on which the questions are asked are curricular and co-curricular activities. The external may ask you what were the co-curricular activities that are conducted in a school, and how did you conduct such kind of activities in your schools. We have co-curricular activities such as essay writing, quiz competition, drawing competition. So these are some of the co-curricular activities that are conducted side by side the curricular activities. And other extracurricular activities such as activities related to sports and games, and also any other extended activities such as Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, or any other activities where you also included the people from the community in your school program. So you can also mention the parent-teacher meeting. If you were a part of any such parents-teacher meeting, then you can also mention such kind of things. So these were some of the commonly asked VIVA questions during BEd internship. In some teacher training institutions, the demand of the external might be different. In our case, we were also asked to take class, and that is to demonstrate all the skills in front of the teachers. So in that case, the teacher was sitting on the front seat, and we were asked to demonstrate in a live classroom, in a real classroom where the students were also there. So we were asked to go in a particular school, and we had to deliver our class in that particular school. The external observe everything and mark according to that. In that case, if you are also supposed to demonstrate, then make sure that you take all the teaching aids with you, and also the pointer that is used. If you are using a chart, then you will also have to bring a pointer. And when you are using a pointer, make sure that you are only using the pointer when you are pointing to the chart, and at the rest of the time, don't use it, just keep it in the table. Because all these things are also observed by the external, and the external will also observe your facial expressions. What are the facial expressions that you use while teaching? And if you stand in the same place for the entire class, or you have moved around in order to check the activity of the students. So they will check out each and every aspect of all the skills, right from introducing a lesson to management of class, to blackboard writing skill, to all the other skills that a teacher use while delivering a class. And the last thing is, your confidence will also matter a lot. Be confident in whatever you say, but don't be overconfident. If you don't understand any question, then ask politely for the external to repeat that question again. Don't reply the wrong answer. Take time and first understand the questions and then reply. So these are the frequently asked questions and things that you need to remember during your VIVA. So at the end, I would say that if this video helps you out in preparation for your VIVA, then do let me know in the comment section below. And if you know someone who is about to face BEd VIVA, then you can also share this video with them. And at the last, if you find my channel useful, then don't forget to subscribe and like my channel. So thank you guys for listening, and see you all in my next video. Till then, take care and stay safe.